Welcome to SAP HXM Mornings. I'm Sven Ringling. I'm an SAP HXM advisor at Orbis People in Germany. Today, I would like to discuss the HXM Move initiative from SAP. And this is quite a lot of cloud to cover, so let's jump right into it. But before we talk about moving to the cloud, let's look at why a lot of customers are not. What is keeping them on-premise? I think there are four main points. Firstly, most SAP HCM on-premise customers would need some kind of hybrid environment in step one, maybe because payroll is still on-premise. And many of them believe that the current integration capabilities are not quite as good as they want them to be. Secondly, especially in the old core markets like Germany, most customers have very sophisticated core HR solutions in on-premise. And they feel that in the cloud solution in SuccessFactors, some features are missing for them. Thirdly, customers who want to go full cloud, including payroll, they find that the current cloud payroll offering from SAP, the so-called SuccessFactors Employee Central Payroll, doesn't really offer them anything new, because it's more or less a copy of the existing on-premise payroll just in cloud. And lastly, those who are prepared to go with Employee Central Payroll, they are often kept down on earth, so to say, because of the time and attendance capabilities they use in on-premise and would not be available with Employee Central Payroll in the cloud. So SAP has listened to this and started the HXM Move initiative to address exactly those four points. So HXM Move is not a product or a tool that does the cloud migration for you, although there are tools available that make some aspects easier. But it's an initiative to make it more attractive for cloud migration in HXM. So how did SAP address the four points? So integration, which is mainly for the hybrid customers, as we said, does get a much improved process and UI integration, the so-called one system experience, where processes that involve data from the on-premise and the cloud solution just go in one flow from a user perspective. Core HR, so Employee Central, is receiving a lot of extra investment to improve, for instance, compensation capabilities like collective agreements, or also improves automation and mass data processing. In time management, there's a whole new module which has grown out of the so-called Employee Central timesheet. Now we have a time management module in SuccessFactors, which is growing a lot in features release on release. And there is an expectation that by 2024, maybe 25 the latest, it will have reached feature parity with the on-premise solution. But even today, a lot of customers can make good use of it. And then payroll. Of course, there is Employee Central Payroll based on what's probably the most comprehensive global payroll engine today. But SAP actually started to develop a completely new payroll based on a new technology. It's called Next Generation Payroll. And what I've seen as a demo looks really very promising to be a completely new modern payroll. However, for most customers, it will probably be several years until that payroll is really available and has the right features for them. Depends also a bit on the country. If you are based in the UK, you are very likely to be the first to be able to use it, maybe as early as next year. So these are the four points. And this is basically all about helping customers to innovate in the cloud. For those customers who are not cloud ready yet at all, there is the so-called private cloud edition. Private cloud we can have a whole new session about this, but if I want to be a little bit sarcastic, private cloud is cloud for people who don't like cloud. So basically in this private cloud edition, you take your on-premise solution, the SAP HCM for S/4HANA on-premise, and kind of lift and shift it into the cloud. It's quite an easy migration that makes it interesting. It doesn't bring you any new capabilities. It could be interesting for many customers because of the service packages that come with the cloud solution and also quite interesting licensing or subscription models. So it's still worth looking at. But in a nutshell, the private cloud edition here with the basically the on-premise system moved into cloud infrastructure is about preservation, to allow customers to do what they have been doing on-premise. And the other four elements of HXM move, they are about innovation. So we expect most customers to do that step sooner or later. But the private cloud edition, as well as the on-premise edition, will probably help to cover the interim stage, especially in a hybrid solution. So there's a lot of details to cover in future sessions, but enough for today. Thank you very much for watching. I wish you a wonderful day with wonderful experiences. Goodbye.